Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Labs module discussing how to estimate total error in RTD measurement systems. This module provides a methodology for estimating initial error, temperature drift error, and total error, as well as describes how to convert errors to different units, such as percent or degrees Celsius. To begin, let's revisit the common error sources found in RTD measurement systems that were introduced in a previous Precision Labs module. Shown here is a typical RTD measurement system that includes a 4-wire RTD connected to a terminal block, a low side reference resistor, an ADC with an integrated PGA and current sources, and a controller to perform the resistance to temperature conversion. As discussed in a previous Precision Labs module, this system has several common error sources. The ADC and amplifier can contribute multiple types of error. In this image, the amplifier is integrated into the ADC package, but the same error analysis applies for a discrete amplifier. In either case, the amplifier and ADC can contribute offset and gain error, linearity errors, and drift errors. While both components can also contribute noise, this topic is not discussed further in this presentation. Instead, refer to the Precision Lab series on ADC noise for a detailed noise analysis. The precision resistor, used to establish a ratiometric reference voltage, can contribute initial accuracy and temperature drift errors. We will assume there is no IDAC error because of the ratiometric reference configuration. However, IDAC mismatch error does need to be considered for 3-wire RTD measurement systems using 2 IDACs. This topic is covered in detail in a previous Precision Labs module discussing challenges with 3-wire RTD systems. Please review that module for more information about errors related to IDAC mismatch. The RTD itself can contribute error in the form of variation in the sensor accuracy, self-heating, and lead wire mismatch. Finally, the controller can introduce computational errors in the resistance to temperature conversion process. While all of these errors are important, the total error calculations only include those errors that come from the signal chain. These errors include the ADC, PGA, and reference resistor errors, and are highlighted in orange. Errors coming from the sensor or from the conversion process are not included in the total error calculations. These types of errors are highlighted in blue. Now that we have identified which error sources are used in the total error calculations, let's step through an example to learn how to estimate total error for a specific ADC. For this example, we will select the ADS124S08 to measure the RTD. This ADC is a 24-bit 13-channel Delta Sigma ADC with an integrated amplifier and current sources that is commonly used for RTD measurements. Next, we need to identify our design specifications. The top left table defines the system parameters, assuming we use the ADS124S08 to measure a PT100 RTD. The bottom left table lists the errors that result from the selected system parameters. Before we can begin the error analysis, however, we need to calculate 3 more system parameters. First, we need the reference voltage, VREF. This value is the product of the IDAC current and the RREF resistance, which is 1.6 volts. One important note about this calculation, as well as subsequent calculations, is that we're using the ideal absolute IDAC current to keep the analysis simple. In practice, the measured voltage could be slightly higher or lower depending on actual IDAC current, but this is acceptable because we are trying to estimate the total error. We will use this convention throughout the rest of this error estimation. Next, we need the full-scale range, or FSR. The specific FSR equation for the ADS124S08 is shown, and the calculated result is 0.4 volts. Third, our estimated error is always calculated at a specific RTD resistance, which in this case is RTD max. Later in this presentation, we will extrapolate these calculations to plot the total error across the entire RTD resistance range. For now, we just need to calculate maximum input voltage to the ADC, Vin max. This value is the product of the ideal IDAC current and the maximum RTD resistance, which is 0.1941 volts. Finally, we can add these values to the system parameters table as shown. Now we can begin estimating the total initial error. To estimate the initial error, let's calculate each error source individually and convert to microvolts. Where applicable, relative errors will be referenced to the maximum input voltage, Vin max. Moreover, the initial error is specified at an ambient temperature of 25 degrees Celsius. Also note that for this example, we will use typical errors because these represent the most statistically likely set of conditions. Refer to the Precision Labs module on statistics behind error analysis for more information about the difference between typical and maximum errors. Typical offset error is specified in microvolts and is given by the equation 20 divided by gain, or 2.5 microvolts for this example. Typical gain error is specified as 40 ppm. Since gain error varies with input voltage, we need to multiply the gain error by Vin max. The typical gain error is 7.76 microvolts for this example. Typical INL is specified as 2 ppm of FSR. Since INL is an absolute error similar to offset, we just need to multiply the INL error in ppm by the FSR. The typical INL is 0.8 microvolts for this example. The ADC noise at the system settings in this example is 0.45 microvolts. Finally, the typical RF accuracy is 0.1%. Similar to gain error, we can convert this to ppm and multiply by Vin max to determine the typical RF accuracy is 194.1 microvolts for this example. Reviewing all these different error sources, it is clear that RF accuracy is the dominant initial error. Now, let's discuss how to calculate total initial error. The table on the left summarizes the errors calculated in the previous slides. Use the following information to calculate total initial error. First, we assume the errors are uncorrelated. This is generally true for the types of errors presented in this module. Operating under this assumption allows us to use the root sum of squares method to calculate total error. The general form of this equation is shown on the right. We can use this formula to calculate a total initial error of 194.27 microvolts at the maximum RTD resistance. Finally, a similar procedure can be used for typical or maximum errors. As noted previously, typical errors are used in this example because this represents the most statistically likely set of conditions. Let's now discuss how to calculate over-temperature errors. A previous Precision Labs module discussing error sources in RTD measurement systems introduced two methods to calculate temperature drift error. The first method uses the datasheet error plots to directly determine the error magnitude at any given temperature. The example plot on the left shows the ADS124S08 offset over the specified temperature range of negative 50 degrees Celsius to 125 degrees Celsius, where the initial error is given as 2.1 microvolts at a gain of 8. One of the challenges with this method is that these types of plots are not available in all datasheets, requiring use of alternative methods to estimate temperature error. When these plots are available, it is possible to directly determine the drift error within the system temperature range. The blue box highlights the temperature range used in this example, which is negative 25 degrees Celsius to 85 degrees Celsius. The largest offset error within this range is 3.2 microvolts. We can then use the equations in the bottom left to back calculate the error due to temperature drift, which is 1.1 microvolts. Differentiating between initial and drift errors allows the user to understand how much error each source contributes. This information can then be used to determine if calibration is necessary to achieve the system accuracy targets. Calibration is discussed in more detail in a subsequent Precision Labs module. The second method uses the specifications given in the electrical characteristics table to determine temperature errors. Example offset and offset drift specifications at a gain of 8 are given in the table on the right. One challenge with this method is that the datasheet drift specifications represent a linear approximation of the error over temperature. If the actual error response is nonlinear, the electrical characteristics method can under or overestimate the error. Review the Precision Labs presentation on error sources to learn more. The benefit of the second method is that these error specifications are available in all datasheets, allowing a fair comparison between different devices or systems. Therefore, estimating temperature error using the electrical specifications is the most common method. We will use this method throughout the rest of this presentation. To calculate temperature errors using the second method, we first need to identify the error calculation temperature range using the temperature gradient on the right. This plot includes the specified temperature range of the ADS124S08, the system measurement range, and the initial error temperature. To identify the error calculation temperature range, subtract T initial error from T min system and T max system, resulting in delta T1 and delta T2, respectively. Taking the absolute value of these numbers and then choosing the larger of the two yields the error calculation temperature range. Applying the resultant values to the equation at the bottom right yields a calculated drift error of 0.9 microvolts. Now, let's apply this information to calculate all of the drift errors in this example. On the previous slide, we calculated the maximum temperature change, delta T, for the system parameters included on the table on the top left. These calculations are shown on the top right, where delta T is 60 degrees Celsius. Now, let's calculate the over-temperature errors. Typical offset drift is specified as 15 nanovolts per degree Celsius. Multiplying this value by delta T and converting to microvolts yields a typical offset drift value of 0.9 microvolts for this example. Typical gain drift is specified as 1 ppm per degree Celsius. Multiplying this value by delta T and Vn max yields a typical gain drift value of 11.65 microvolts for this example. Typical RF drift is specified as 5 ppm per degree Celsius. Multiplying this value by delta T and Vn max yields a typical RF drift value of 58.23 microvolts for this example. Reviewing all of these different error sources, it is clear that the RF drift dominates the total system error across temperature. The next slide summarizes these results. Before calculating total error, let's recall the initial error values and the total initial error derived previously in this presentation. The initial error values are highlighted in purple in the table on the left, while the total error is shown in the equation on the top right. Next, let's include the temperature errors calculated on the previous slide. These values are highlighted in blue in the table on the left. We calculate the total error at the maximum RTD resistance using the same root sum of squares formula that was used to calculate the total initial error. This is shown at the bottom right as 203.15 microvolts. The key takeaway from this analysis is that the RF errors dominate the overall error budget in this example, not the ADC. Therefore, it is imperative to choose a high-accuracy, low-drift RF for best system performance. A 0.1% accurate component with a 5 ppm per degree Celsius drift specification is recommended. Next, let's extrapolate this analysis to include the entire RTD resistance range and not just the maximum value. On the left are the ADC and system settings we have been using throughout this example. In the last slide, we calculated the initial error, temperature error, and total error at the maximum RTD resistance of 194.1 ohms. Let's perform that same analysis across the entire input range. On the right is a plot of the error in microvolts with respect to RTD resistance. The blue plot represents only the total temperature drift error, the purple plot represents only the total initial error, and the brown plot shows the total combined initial and over temperature errors. Interestingly, all of these plots just look like a typical gain error plot. However, this makes sense because the RF error dominates the overall error budget, both initially and over temperature. Therefore, the resulting total error across RTD resistance can just be approximated as the RF error. That concludes the error estimation portion of this presentation. The final topic, discussed on the next slide, introduces how to convert error in microvolts to different units. Throughout this presentation, we've talked about error using different units, including microvolts and percent. Now, let's discuss how to convert between these units. We'll also identify how to calculate error in degrees Celsius, which is a common requirement in RTD measurement systems. First, the formula on the top left calculates the error in percent by taking the error in volts and dividing by the input voltage, then multiplying by 100. Note that this formula can be reversed if the error is given percent and needs to be converted back to a voltage. As an example, we previously calculated a total initial error of 194.27 microvolts for an input voltage of 0.1941 volts. This is equivalent to a 0.1% error, which is highlighted in yellow in the top right. Comparatively, the equation for converting error in microvolts to error in degrees Celsius is shown on the bottom left. This equation divides the error in microvolts by the product of the ideal IDAC current in microamps and the RTD sensitivity to generate the error in degrees Celsius. Since sensitivity is a new parameter, let's discuss it in more detail. The equation for sensitivity is also shown on the bottom left. Sensitivity is the absolute difference between two RTD resistances divided by the difference in their corresponding temperatures. These RTD resistances and temperatures are determined using polynomial equations, or lookup tables, as described in a previous Precision Labs module. For example, several values for a PT100 RTD are given in the table on the right. These values are taken from a standard lookup table that has a resolution of 1 degree Celsius. Inputting two sets of adjacent values into the sensitivity equation produces the sensitivity numbers in the last column. Note that the values do not need to be adjacent to calculate the sensitivity. Also note that a PT100 generally becomes more sensitive as temperature increases. Applying the average sensitivity value from the table to the error equation yields an error of 0.54 degrees Celsius. If this result is unacceptably high, calibration is necessary. Please review a subsequent Precision Labs module on calibration techniques to learn more. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of this video's content. Question 1. Why is the square root sum of the squares used to add error sources? The correct answer is B. The errors are random and uncorrelated, so this is a good statistical method to calculate total error. Question 2. Calculating drift error using the datasheet drift specification assumes that the drift is linear over temperature. Is this assumption always true? The correct answer is B, no. Drift error cannot be assumed to be linear over temperature.